There's the signal now. The light is flashing on the gates and they're ready at the 1,000. Stand by for start. They're off and they're racing as well. Shock Result got away brilliantly. So did Wins a Lot from wide out. Miss Bougainvillea pushing up. And right there as well is the favourite, Mystical View, who'd settled right on speed early. Over on its outside is Keep Your Feet, being followed by Hollyoak. Back on the inside, Nobel Star getting back with Tarawa by Felicia. And the tail ender is Comanche Cat as they settle properly. 550 from home. Up towards the home corner now, and Miss Bougainvillea has kicked right up on the inside to get on equal terms with Shock Result there together. 1.5 to Wins a Lot, which is the wider of them. In behind them came Mystical View, travelling beautifully into the corner for Pike. He's switching back to the cutaways, going the same pathway as he did to win the first on the card. As Shock Result reaches the lead, sprints away, 200 to go. Now Pike starts to stoke up Mystical View, who's going easily. In fact, it's in second gear with 100 to run. Mystical View shoots through, grabs Shock Result, comes away and does it untouched. Goes down to win it easily, Mystical View. A length and a half, Shock Result. Keep Your Feet may have just snatched third in a photo with Hollyoak close up. Running on very well, the grey, Comanche Cat from back in the field. And then came By Felicia, Wins a Lot. Followed home further back in the field by Nobel Star. The last two in were the tiring Miss Bougainvillea. And it pulled up very abruptly back there towards the tail end of the field. And also pulling up sharply, Tarawa. So it's Cerise and White after the first two races here on the card, and that was soft. The Canford Cliffs filly, she has signalled her great potential. That was a very, very easy victory here for a filly having her first outing. Well-bred filly by Canford Cliffs. Pike jumped away with them, up there prominent throughout. Speed taken care of by Shock Result, who had to work outside of Miss Bougainvillea, who dropped right out. Shock Result stuck on, so it was an admirable effort there in defeat at the hands of a filly that clearly has got plenty of motor. She was always going better than Shock Result, just a matter of when Pike wanted to put a little bit of pressure on Mystical View, and he's gone exactly the same pathway to win the first 2,000-metre races on the car. Just allowed her to drift up the track a bit more. He had the room to do it. And she responded well. Just simple hands and heels, just kept the bit between the teeth, and she worked through the gears accordingly, pricked her ears up, and did the job like it was an exercise gallop. Mystical View, one to keep on following quite clearly. Shock Result, nice effort by the Safeguard Colt out of Democratism, Paul Jordan, Craig Staples, and one Keep Your Feet, got the judge's nod there for third placing, a Bradbury's Luck two-year-old from Shandian, Simon Miller and Kate Southam. Fourth home, number 7, Hollyoak. 9217, a nice effort, Comanche Cat as well from last, made up considerable ground late. A length and a half by 1.5. The time a little slower than the first. It's 1:07.0. 1:07.0, home in 34.57, but had reserves in the tank. As we take a look at the third, the Perth Racing at Home maiden, again 1,000 metres at 12.39, 11.12.13 the scratchings, capacity of 10 to run there in the next. Let's go down to Brittany Taylor, and Grant Williams described the two winners so far as being pretty equal in ability, although that seemed to me a bit more impressive, Mystical View.
Definitely did, Darren. I think Grant may have been a little bit modest in his assessment of this filly after the winner of the last. Grant, how do you view that race? Darren just saying that the time was a bit slower, but the way that she did it appeared more impressive than the first horse.
Yeah, look, she's probably... The trip probably suits her better, Brit, like we just spoke about. She is pretty forward and probably a lot stronger. She looked like she'd done it a little bit easier.
This horse we saw really travelling. You mentioned probably better suited at this sort of trip. She's probably, is she one that you're not really wanting to jump up in distance too quickly at this stage of her career?
Looking at that, I definitely think not. Obviously, Bob will, he'll have the final say, but just looking at the way she raced and maybe they were going a touch slow, we'd probably have to keep her shorter.
The way she was able to run away and have her ears pricked on the line, does that to you suggest just how easy she was doing it today?
Yeah, well, look, Lance is like this one from the start. He's obviously got a soft spot. Mystery Miss was always a stable favourite, so she's obviously had a special place as soon as she come in and just does everything really well at home. So we're quietly confident.
How do you compare her to her sister, Mystery Miss?
Look, she was a very nice filly, Mystery Miss, but this one's probably... does it a little bit easier, whereas Mystery Miss got back out the back and would smoke home. She sort of puts herself in a bit of a spot and is a little bit more go-y type.
And as a type looking at her, are they similar?
Very, very similar, yeah. Both strong build, stocky horses, yeah, very similar.
Well, that's easy done day for you. Two from two, well done.
Thank you.
Grant Williams, and easy as you like. William Park just having a word with him. We'll see if we can get a word with Willie, and we'll just see if we can grab him. Willie, do you mind if we grab you in front of the microphone to get a word from the jock and hear about these two horses winning the first two races? Compare the pair, Willie, from the first winner to this one. How do you compare the two?
One's very instant, and you've got to be careful which buttons you press because you might get too much. And the first one, she's very laid back, and actually her win, I think, probably had as much or more merit because I didn't get a lot of galloping room, and we did it from off the bridle, which is really hard to do. And this second girl, she's obviously always had an opinion. She's always gone good, so it's nice to get the result.
Is it a case of the first one will probably be better over further, whereas this one can do it right now over 1,000?
Yeah, most likely. I think that's probably the case. One's sort of got the mile plus stamped on her, and this one might be the sprinting option, but I wouldn't put it beyond her to run further either. They seem to be able to do anything.
They absolutely do. They just are able to do everything. Well done on the early double.
Thank you.
William Park, a quick word from him after his first two victories in the Cerise and White, and the Peter's Investments train just keeps on rolling through. Two very nice horses. Mystical View winning the Turf Club Plate.